Welcome to the course on 3034 Mechanical Engineering. In this lecture, we are discussing about differential manometers. So we have already studied about simple U-tube manometers. We know that simple U-tube manometers are used for measuring the pressure of fluid flowing through a pipe. It will give the gauge pressure at a particular location in a pipe flow. A differential manometer is used for measuring the difference of pressure between two points in a pipe or in two different pipes. Suppose we have two pipes, there are two different fluids are flowing through this pipe, or sometimes same fluid is flowing through the pipes. If we want to measure the pressure difference between these two pipes, we have to use a differential manometers. Or in some other case, the differential manometer is also used for measuring the pressure difference between two points in a same pipe. Suppose if this is a pipe, through this pipe a fluid is flowing through this pipe, and let A is a point and B is another point, A and B. If you want to measure the pressure difference between these two pipes, we have to use a differential manometer. Under that condition, the U-tube manometer will be connected in such a way that one limb is connected to point A and another limb is connected to point B. So in this way, we can measure the pressure difference between point A and point B. That is PA minus PB. The pressure difference between these two points can be calculated with the help of a U-tube manometer. So under this condition, this manometer is known as a U-tube differential manometer. Now, in another case, we have two pipes. This is pipe A, and we have another pipe. This is pipe B, and here water is flowing through this pipe, and through this pipe water or oil or anything is flowing. Suppose we want to find the pressure difference between difference of pressure between pipe A and B. What we can do, we can connect a U-tube differential manometer in such a way that one limb is connected to pipe A and another limb will be connected to pipe B. Under this condition, it will look like this. You can see the cross section of this pipe. Pipe A will be this. Cross section of pipe B will be like this. And U-tube manometer is connected to pipe A and pipe B. Okay. So in the case of simple manometers, one end is connected to the pipe and other end was open to the atmosphere. But in the case of differential U-tube manometer, both ends will be connected to pipes. Sometimes both ends will be connected to the same pipe, or in another case, the ends will be connected to different pipes. Okay. A differential manometer consists of a U-tube containing heavy liquid. That liquid is known as manometric liquid. Usually mercury is used. Whose two ends are connected to the points whose difference of pressure is to be measured. Now, we can do two problems related to differential manometers. So, the first question, a U-tube mercury manometer is connected to two pipes A and B. Pipe B is 60 mm below pipe A. The specific gravity of liquid in pipe A and B is 1.6 and 0.85 respectively. Mercury level in the left limb is 80 mm below the center of pipe A. Find the pressure difference between two pipes if the level difference of mercury in the two limbs of manometer is 120 mm. So here we are using a differential U-tube manometer, and the manometer is connected to two pipes A and B. So the first parameter given is the difference between the height difference between pipe A and B. So this is the cross section of pipe A. This is pipe B. This is pipe A and this is pipe B. So this is the center of the pipe A, center of pipe B. So pipe B is 60 mm below pipe A. So you can see that the distance, you can see there is a mark known as H1. What is this H1? H1 is the distance between center of pipe A to center of pipe B. So distance between pipe A and B is 60 mm. That is, here pipe B is 60 mm below pipe A, means the value of H1 is equal to 60 mm. Then another parameter given is the specific gravity of liquid in pipe A. So that's a given parameter. Specific gravity of liquid in pipe A. Specific gravity of liquid in pipe A is equal to 1.6. So density of fluid. Density of fluid in pipe A is equal to, density of fluid in pipe A, I am denoting as rho A, is equal to 1.6 into density of water, 1000, is equal to 1600 kilogram per meter cube. So this is the density, this is a pipe A. The density of fluid flowing through this pipe A is 1600 kilogram per meter cube. Yes, specific gravity of fluid in pipe B is equal to 0.85. Hence density of fluid in pipe B, I am denoting it as rho B, is equal to 0.85 into density of water, which is equal to 850 kilogram per meter cube. Which is given that mercury level in the left limb is 80 mm below the center of pipe A. Mercury level, so you can see that in this figure, this colored liquid is the manometric fluid, mercury. This colored liquid is the manometric fluid, mercury. The mercury level in the left limb is 80 mm below the center of pipe A. Mercury level in the left limb is 80 mm below the center of pipe A. So here from this figure you can see that this is the center of pipe A. This is the level difference, level of mercury in the left limb. So this distance, send from center of pipe A to the mercury level in the left limb, this distance is H2. So H2 is equal to 80 mm. H2 is equal to 80 mm. So here H2 is equal to 80 mm. And another parameter given is, the level difference of mercury in the two limbs of manometer is 120 mm. So this is the left limb, and this is the right limb, this is the left limb, and this is the right limb. The level difference of mercury in the two limbs, that is this, from this point to this point, the height is marked, denoted as HM. That is, HM is, the level difference is 120 mm. So we can note as HM is equal to 120 mm. Now we have to find the pressure difference between points A and B. That is, our aim is to find PA minus PB. We have to find PA minus PB. The parameters, all other parameters are given. We have to find PA minus PB, pressure difference between pipe A and pipe B. So before finding the pressure difference, first we have to mark the reference line. So reference line is marked along the separation of fluid in right limb. So here, this is up to this point, this is mercury, and we will draw a reference line through this point. This is our reference line. Reference line will pass through the intersection of fluids in the right limb. So here there is a fluid flowing through the pipe B, and here it is a mercury. So this is our reference line. Now what we will do, we will equate the pressure acting above reference line in above in left and right limb. So what you will get? You will get, so this is our reference line. So considering the left limb, above the reference line in left limb, the pressure acting are pressure of fluid flowing through pipe A, PA plus. There is a, so pressure due to this liquid column having height H2, rho A G H2 plus pressure exerted by mercury column having height HM. This is height HM. Rho HG G HM, which is equal to PB plus, we have to find the height of liquid column above reference line in the right limb. So up to this point, it is HM. This is HM and this is H2 minus H1. This distance is, I am marking it as X. I am marking this small distance as X. And from center of point B, center of pipe B, up to this point, up to the reference line, there is a liquid column having height HM plus X, PB plus rho B into G into HM plus X. So how we find the value of X? So from this figure you can see that H2 is equal to H1 plus X. H2 is equal to H1 plus X. So what will be X? X is equal to H2 minus H1. This 80 minus 60 is equal to 20 mm. 20 mm. Okay. So we have PA plus what is rho A? rho a we have already determined. Rho a is 1600 and rho b is 850. Process 9.81 into H2. This H2 is 80 mm. That is 80 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter plus pressure head due to the mercury column height HM. The mercury column height is HM is 120 mm. Here I know the density of mercury 13600 into 9.81 into 120 into 10 raised to minus 3. Which is equal to PB plus the consume the right limb. The density of liquid flowing through the pipe B is rho B is 850. 850 into 9.81 into this height. Height is this is marked as X HM plus X. So HM is 120. Plus X is 20, so total 140. 140 mm, which is 140 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. So which implies, which gives PA plus PA plus 17,000. 265.6 is equal to PB plus 1167.39. Okay, so we have to find PA minus PB. Or which is equal to 17265.6 minus PA minus PB is equal to 1167.39 minus 17265.6 is equal to 1609.821 newton per meter square per pascal. What does minus sign indicate? PA minus PB is equal to minus 1609.8. That means PB is greater than PA. The pressure of fluid flowing through the pipe B is greater than pressure of fluid flowing through pipe A. So we can write PB minus PA is equal to PB minus PA is equal to 1609.821 newton per meter square of pascal. So PB is greater than PA, so you will get the pressure difference between two pipes A and B.